Good afternoon, this is the second lecture regarding EE570, that is power system instrumentation, in which the best thing whatever I have taken, this is from a research paper, and this research paper has been devised by MVLS Nishin Anthony, Sandeep T, Sudesh Kumar M and Vishnu Balakrishnan. All of them are from EEE, that means Electrical and Electronics Engineering, MARE, Athanasius College of Engineering, Kotamangalam. And this particular thing, it was published in International Journal of Advanced Research in Electrical, Electronics and Instrumentation Engineering, May 2014, in their third volume and fifth issue. And the topic is actually automatic meter reading and load management using PLCC, power line carrier communication. Before also we have run through PLCC. So here, let me just increase the okay. So, if we will go like this, then here we can see that, of course, energy crisis, this is a burning problem in the present day society. Whether there will be any type of instrument, any type of system that will control energy, of course, in for any type of suitable system, if it has to control the energy, then it should find out the solution for its crisis. Now you can see over here, it is given that load shedding, power cut, etc. helps to rearrange the available power. That means there will be, at that time, there will be some amount of power will be rearranged or accumulated, but they can't be used to prevent the unwanted usage of energy. Of course, that is the truest thing. The unwanted uses of energy by the use of, by doing load, by executing load shedding or power cut, we cannot make up that thing. Peak time load control, that is another thing. Now, so a system is needed to monitor the power consumption of an overall area, to select the areas to suitably control the energy usage. Of course, there should be a monitoring system. One of the easiest solution is what? That is power line communication, or you can say power line carrier communication, PLCC. Before also we have indicated this thing. Now PLC is the communication technology, as you can see over here, it is written, it is a communication technology that enables sending data over existing power cables. This means that with just power cables running to an electrical device, one can power it up and at the same time control or retrieve data from the device in full duplex manner, that means in to and fro. What will be the major advantage of this power line communication is that it does not need any extra cable. It uses only the existing wire, and thus by using power line communication we can control and monitor the usage of devices by providing a control, the usage of devices at the consumer end, for the control circuit, for the console, everything. So power line communication is a very important thing, and hence for this research paper the keywords are with automatic meter reading, power line communication, electronic meter, as well as modulation and demodulation unit, that is modem. Now we can see over here, in this paper, it is practically, it is mainly focused for the purpose of getting a fully automatic electricity billing system. What is the aim of this project is just to measure and monitor the electricity that will be consumed by consumers in a locality, and it has to be transmitted, whatever the readings is being measured, that should be transmitted between the consumer and the utility. It also helps in reducing any type of malpractices and any type of unwanted things and damages of the meter. Using this system to electricity, using this system, any electricity board can access all data regarding the consumed power at each household or each home, actually, at each residence. The system can monitor the power usage and it can also warn the users, that means whoever be the subscribers, when the power usage is getting close to the prescribed energy usage level, that means a threshold level, a padding level. It also possesses the capability of to automatically turn off the low priority devices. Of course, we have to see the high priority devices for which we have to use it so frequently, and low priority devices, better turn off those low priority devices. What will be the use of those energy that will be associated with low priority devices? And then when the load limit exceeds threshold level during peak hour. The concept of power line communication is used for the transfer of data between the consumer and utility, and this power line communication uses high power line for communication, that means HT. Now the data is transmitted at a higher frequency than of the transmission frequency. Of course, the data should be transmitted at higher carrier frequency. The main advantage of this method is no additional transmission line is required for the transmission of data. Now you can see over here there are traditional billing systems which is now present. It is very discrete, inaccurate, moreover it is costly, slow, and it will lack the flexibility as well as reliability. Therefore, several attempts were made to automate the billing systems. Even though accurate and fast readings are obtained nowadays, bill payment is still performed based on the old billing procedure. Why should it be like that? So they require an individual or an agent to physically come and take down the readings and report to the household office or household system, or you can say house or office, the amount that one has to pay. Now it also acts as a suitable system to control the energy usage, load shedding, power cut, etc. As I told before also, it will help to rearrange the available power, but they can't be used to prevent the unwanted usage of energy or peak time load control, etc. And also there a system is needed to monitor the power consumption of an overall area to select the areas to suitably control the energy usage. Now there are so many related works in this power line carrier communication, so many review literature will be there. Researchers are doing rigorous work for this, because this is a type of real world power line communication and smart metering by which efficiency of power system, analysis of power efficiency of power system can be enhanced. Analysis of power system can be done in smooth way. Now, actually, whatever be the working principle, that will be depending on these things. The whole project is divided into four systems. First one is load management system. Second one is meter reading system. Third one is graphical user interface. And fourth one is PLC unit. Let us see the first one. The first one in the load management system, what is the main aim? It is the effective management of the load as the consumer side, because the consumer is only using it. A microcontroller will be there, which is a dedicated system. It is provided to each consumer side, that means to each subscriber, who will control the load. In this system, whatever be the peak time that is being decided by the total load that is connected to the utility, and that will not be a fixed one. That means that particular thing, that is the peak time which is being connected to the load, total load which is being associated to the utility, is not a fixed one. So a predetermined peak value is initially set in the microcontroller, and if the power consumption exceeds that predetermined value, then the microcontroller initially warns the consumer or the subscriber through the LCD module. It may be any type of LCD module, it may be 16x24x anything. If no action is performed by the consumer, then of course the consumer, once the consumer will be warned, the consumer should take some action. But if at all no action will be performed by the consumer, then the controller cuts off the supply to certain devices in prioritized manner. First the low priority manner, and then to medium, and then to high. A priority list of devices can be preset in the microcontroller. Of course, how can the microcontroller will understand if at all it will not be preset in the microcontroller on which the cutoff is done? So this is the first thing for load management system. Now the second thing, that is meter reading system. In this meter reading system, the system is kept in synchronizing with the utility. Each and every consumer is provided with a unique address which is stored in the microcontroller as well as the utility data bank. And when the meter reading of a particular consumer is being done, the utility sends the required address through this power line, of course high transmission power line. Now the required consumer microcontroller is uniquely identified, and the microcontroller is instructed to read the meter, and this meter reading is being taken with the help of the blinking pulses. Of course there will be pulses comprising of zeros and ones, blinking pulses, and the reading is returned to the utility, and at the utility the required calculations are done, and then the bill details are retransmitted, and then microcontroller again displays in the LCD module. So you can see it is a to and fro communication, a duplex communication. This information is also saved in the data bank for future use, because it will be saved in the data bank as per monthly pattern. Now the third is graphical user interface, or GUI. It is the interface that is provided for the load management or billing at the utility side. What it will do, it will help the utility to properly manage the meter details of each consumer, and it is created using a special toolbox called Guide in MATLAB software. Of course we have to do it by MATLAB also. Next, the fourth one, power line control communication, or power line carrier communication, PLC unit. It is the modem system of the setup. It will do the modulation and demodulation for the data that is to be sent through the power line, and here we are using frequency shift keying modulation technique, and it is placed at the consumer as well as at the utility side for transmission and reception and vice versa. So this type of communication is actually serial communication. Now the methodology. First of all, we will come to the hardware description. In the hardware description, the consumer section of the automatic electricity billing, what will it be having? It will be having the five things. The first of one will be the energy meter measuring unit, that is consisting of a digital energy meter and a light dependent resistor. That means there should be an LDR. Then the second one is a switching unit that is working with the help of relays. The third one is a control unit which is used to control the process that will be taking place. That should be a microcontroller. Here we are using an Ampega 16 microcontroller. The fourth one will be an LCD module. The fifth one is PLC modem that is being employed as the wireless communication module. Now the data monitoring section, that is also present at the utility site, and this section being consisting of these following things. So what are the following things? The first one is a central control unit, or CCU, which is mainly nothing but a computer, and it completely controls the utility using a graphical user interface, or GUI. And the second one is a data bank that will refer to the memory where all the information about different consumers will be stored. Now if I will come to PLC modem, this is the PLC modem, power line carrier communication. You can see over here the meter unit is in conjugation with control unit, which is in conjugation with display. The PLC modem is in duplex with the control unit. Control unit is in connection with the switching unit. PLC modem is in duplex with another PLC modem. It is in duplex with central control unit CCU. It is in conjugation with data bank. This is the consumer section. This is the data monitoring section, which we told just now. Now we can see over here the main hardware components that will be used for this thing. One is energy measuring unit. What is an energy measuring unit? It will be consisting of a standard calibrated energy meter, which will be calibrated with respect to a particular reference, and light dependent resistor. Now, in with that light dependent resistor, of course, infrared light dependent resistor we will be using. It is placed in the top of the energy meter to sense the blinking of the LED, that means the light emitting diodes in the energy meter. Now the digital energy meter works on the basis of the flash that will be made by the LEDs. This flash is detected by the use of that light dependent resistor. It will sense the blinking of the energy meter LED and it will compare with the reference voltage with help of a comparator. That means one comparator circuit will be there. If the output of the comparator is high, then the number of units counting will be incremented in the microcontroller. The output comparator is given directly to a pulse counter section in ATmega 16A microcontroller. It counts the number of pulses and proportion, it will convert to the proportional energy that is consumed. This is the first energy measuring unit, and the second one is an energy meter. It is an electricity meter, that is a device which will measure the amount of electric energy that will be consumed within a residence, in a business center, in a business mall, electrically or any electrically powered device. This is typically calibrated in billing units, the most common one being the kilowatt hour, kWh. Now periodic readings we have to take for electricity meters, which will establish billing cycles, that is the billing of particular billing of particular house, say within a time period, that is the billing cycle, and energy that is used during a cycle. Electronic meters display the energy used on an LCD or LED. It can provide LED display, and some can also transmit readings to remote places. This is one unique thing of PLC. In addition to measuring energy used, electronic meters can also record the parameters of the load as well as supply, such as instantaneous and maximum rate of usage demands, voltages, power factor, reactive power use, etc. They can also support time of day billing, means at what time in which the billing is being done. For example, recording the amount of energy used during on peak and off peak hours. For the energy meter used for this project, it has been shown over here, 3200 LED blinking corresponds to one unit of energy consumption. Now we are coming to the next slide. In this one, we can see this is particular energy meter, whatever we are seeing in our household. Now the third portion is very important. This is the microcontroller. It is nothing but ATmega 16A, flash EEPROM and static RAM. Flash EEPROM, of course, electrical, erasable, programmable, read-only memory, static RAM, all of them are integrated on this single chip, and this particular chip is nothing but a 40-pin IC, removing the need for any external memory, because memory is embedded in this. Some devices have parallel external bus for the option to allow additional data memory or memory map devices. Almost all devices except the smallest tiny AVR chips, all of them have serial interfaces which can be used to connect larger serial electrical, erasable, programmable, read-only memories or flash chips. Now I am coming to the next one, that is the PLC modem. See, it is mostly useful to send and receive serial data over existing AC mains, because we are telling about HT power lines, so existing AC mains power lines of the buildings. It has high immunity to electrical noise persistence in the power line because it will nullify the effect of noise, and built-in error checking, so it never gives out the corrupt data. It will always give the right optimized data. The modem is in form of a ready use to use the circuit model, which is capable of providing 9600 baud rate or BPS, you can say. It is a low rate bi-directional data communication. Due to its small size, it can be integrated into and become part of user's power line data communication system. This module provides bi-directional half duplex communication over the line. You can see over here, there you can go for any voltage up to 250 volt AC or for frequency 50 or 60 Hertz. Half duplex communication means you can see the PCB board, and that is shown over here for this power line communication, this PLC modem. Half duplex communication means it can either transmit or receive data at a time, but not both at the same time. Normally module is in the receiving mode all the time, listening to the incoming communication that will come on the power line. Once the application gives the serial data that will be on transmission to RXIP IN pin, means receiving the data as an input pin, it switches over to transmit and transmits the data through power line. Once transmit process is complete, it switches back to the receive mode. The transmission data of the data then indicated by this red LED, as you can see over here, this particular part, red LED. The reception of data by the modem is used by the green LED, as you can see over here, which is on TXTX, mean transmission out pin, means data is being transmitted at the output and it will be received as an input. Data communication of the modules is transparent to users' data terminal and protocol independent, and as a result, multiple units can be connected to the mains without affecting the operation of others. There is no hassle of building interface circuits. Interface to user data devices is a simple data in, data out serial link. So it's a very easy thing. Now you can see over here, this transmission is based on byte to byte basis. That means byte to byte basis means first 8 bit data will go, then again 8 bit data, like that. Once you give 1 byte to module for transmission, you will have to wait for at least 500 milliseconds before, that means that is the resting or wait time period, that means for the next data to come, that means next 8 bit or next new byte, and it is given to module again. Since the module waits for zero crossing of AC mains to transfer one particular bit, for AC of 50 Hertz system, the zero crossing of AC signal happens every 10 milliseconds, and the modem needs actually 50 zero crossings to transmit one byte with error checking data. After that, it is very important, that is why it takes 500 milliseconds for one byte. For example, if we want to transmit the character test, then we will have to transmit first T, then you have to wait for 500 milliseconds, then transmit E, then again wait for 500 milliseconds, then transmit S, wait for 500 milliseconds, and then again transmit T and wait for 500 milliseconds. All total 2000 milliseconds. This can be quite slow speed for big data transfer, but the purpose of this module is to transfer small data bytes like sensor reading and remote control, for which the speed is okay to implement. After that, the utility center is over there. The utility center or the electricity board is actually resides at the utility company and consists of power line communication modem, carrier control modem actually, and it is a PC. It is you can say it is a PC in a console that will be using with the details of power consumption from the consumer unit, which is obtained via communication network. Also, there will be a serial, universal serial bus converter, which is used for level conversion. The software MATLAB is used to receive data and also to send bill amount to the consumer. We are using guide toolbooks inside the MATLAB to make a user-friendly GUI or graphical user interface. After that, you can see over here relay and relay control. Of course, a high power relay, that is a very vital part in this system, and it provides useful functionality of switching the power in on or off mode to user based on the signal to send the signal that will be sent to it from controller corresponding to the status of bill payment. Now, a relay is nothing but an electrically controllable switch which is widely used in industrial controls, in automobiles, in appliances, and which will allow the isolation of two separate sections of a system with two different voltage sources, that is a small amount of voltage or current on one side which can handle a large amount of voltage or current on the other side, but there is no chance of these two voltages or current can mix up, and when current flows through the relay coil, a magnetic field is created around the coil, that means the coil is energized. This causes the armature to be attracted towards the coil. The armature contacts acts like a switch for this and closes or opens the circuit. So after that, if the coil is not energized, then a spring pulls the armature to its normal state of open or close. There are actually all types of relays for all kinds of application. When a command is received by the microcontroller to disconnect or reconnect the load by using this relay, the operation is performed. A solid state relay uses a thyristor. We are knowing this NPNP device, a thyristor, or other solid state switching device that is activated by control signal to switch the control load instead of a solenoid. You can see over here the type of relay instead of a solenoid or a coil. A high power relay, actually this is a vital part in the system which is providing useful functionality of the switching power that will be in either in on or off condition to the user based on the signal that will be sent to it from the controller corresponding to the status of bill payment. It consists of a relay and the transistor and its transistor driving circuit. Generally, the transistor that will be using as NPN BC547, and here we can also use 12 volt relay as a switch. After that, this portion is coming in which there will be power supply. In the power supply, these two portions are very important. One is step down transformer, which is one where the secondary voltage is less than that of primary voltage. We can use 12.0.12, we can use 6.0.6. Generally, we are using 12.0.12, which is designed to reduce the voltage from primary winding to the secondary winding, and this kind of transformer steps down the voltage applied to it. As a step down unit, the transformer converts high voltage low current power into low voltage high current power, and the larger gauge well, if we will use in the secondary winding, it is necessary due to increase in the current. The primary winding, which does not have to conduct as much current, may be made of smaller gauge well. After that, of course, bridge rectifier and filter will be coming. Bridge rectifier, we can know that it will be a combination of four diodes to achieve full wave rectification. Of course, voltage regulator, which we will be using, that will be of 7805, which will provide plus 5 volt regulated power supply, and we can be using also capacitors of suitable values over here. And after that, of course, GUI and MATLAB will be coming over there, graphic user interface and MATLAB. One very important thing, there should be event driven programming, that's why we are using MATLAB over here. And after that, As per that MATLAB and GUI, we can create the code files that will generate the GUIs as functions or PIP, which is nothing but programmatic GUI construction. And as a result, this has been shown over here, which is nothing but an implemented circuit, model of the implemented circuit, which is being shown over here. It consists of the control circuit at the consumer side. Each bulb is actually representing different consumer circuits. Serial communication will be here. Graphical user interface will be there. And as I told you, consumer circuit will be here also. So this is the particular thing, and by this I am completing this particular portion of automatic meter reading and billing. Thank you very much.